how to lower your blood pressure through breathing. In this video, you're gonna know all the details. My name is Dr. Story. I've been a chiropractor for over 24 years. I'm gonna give you some realistic advice based on my experience. Now, in this video, I'm gonna show you two specific methods on how to lower your blood pressure through breathing methods. Now, there are two benefits, and both of these methods that I'm gonna show you have these benefits. There are short-term benefits and long-term benefits. Now, the short-term benefits, if you want to watch another video where I took my own blood pressure, did the breathing, and then took the blood pressure again, you could see the results in that video. I'll put a link down in the description of that video. But there are many short-term benefits of this breathing method that I'm going to show you. And one of them is, for the short term, you are lowering your blood pressure, or at least making it somewhat normal. The benefits of this are, it's almost like, listen, we all have stress in our lives. Sometimes we just need to take a vacation from the stress. There are short-term benefits of lowering your blood pressure, but there are also long-term benefits of doing these breathing methods. And the long-term benefits are that if you continue to do them on a daily basis, as I recommend to my patients, then overall, over the long term, you will have benefits of lowering your blood pressure and keeping it that way. In addition to doing other things such as getting your diet right and doing exercise, but that's not the subject of this video. The subject of this video is how to lower your blood pressure through breathing. So, many people are opposed to doing this because they feel as though this is only a temporary lowering of your blood pressure. It is. That's the short-term benefits. But the long-term benefits, you have to use an analogy. And the analogy is brushing your teeth. Brushing your teeth. One could argue that brushing your teeth is a waste of time because it's only temporary, just like breathing lowers your blood pressure. Sure, you brush your teeth, and then as soon as you eat, your teeth are dirty again. So what's the point? Those are the people that are opposed to even trying this. But the long-term benefits of doing this breathing are similar to the long-term benefits of brushing your teeth. Sure, for the short term, brushing your teeth only keeps them clean until you eat again. But if you brush your teeth twice a day, forever, it has many long-term benefits. The same is true with the deep breathing. So, the breathing methods I'm going to show you in just a minute, you do every single day, at least once a day, for about 5 minutes. So let me get on the ground and let me just show you how to do this. Okay, so what I'm doing right now is I'm just sitting down on the floor, I'm relaxed, I'm sitting cross-legged, you can't see that on the video, but what I'm doing is I have my palms up and I just place them on my knees. And I'm just gonna try to relax my shoulders. And what I'm gonna do is I'm going to breathe in through the nose and out through the mouth. And I'm gonna try not to allow my chest to move at all. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna be breathing with my belly. And you can't really see this per se, but my belly is coming out and then my belly's going in. My belly comes out, my belly goes in. So I'm just gonna do some deep breathing, and what I like to do is, and I like to suggest this to patients that like to try this method, is to do 30 slow, calm, deep breaths. Now, make sure you heard that it's slow, it's deep, and it's calm. It's not hyperventilation, okay? So it kind of looks like this. And that is it. Slow, calm, deep breathing. You'll notice that when I breathed in, my belly came out. When I blew the air out, my belly went in. if you rewind a little bit and you watch my shoulders, you'll see that my shoulders really weren't moving that much. So that is method number one. What I recommend is about 30 slow, deep breaths. You put in the comment section down below if you've done this before, how often you do this form of deep breathing. Now, the second form of deep breathing is more of a full body, full diaphragmatic, full chest, into your soul, deep breathing. And this is more if you know about, like, for example, Wim Hof, this is how the deep breathing goes. And there's less emphasis on whether you should breathe in through the nose or out through the mouth. The reason why this works for some people is because it primarily stimulates the parasympathetic nervous system. And what that does is it causes a relaxation of your entire body and the muscles of the inner linings of your arteries. So how this works is it doesn't matter whether it's in through the nose, out through the mouth, it really doesn't make any difference. But you're going to start with the diaphragmatic breathing, and as soon as your air fills up into your belly, then you start filling up your chest cavity. Your chest will come out, the sides of your chest will go out, and you're going to breathe in from your entire soul. And when you think you cannot get any more air in, you do more. So let me demonstrate for you exactly how to do this. Here we go. And you just blow the air out and just totally chill out. Chill out. That's a California thing, by the way. Now notice, you probably couldn't hear it, but as soon as it sounded like I could get the most amount of air in, I kept going. This actually is an exercise for your ribs and the musculature of your rib cage. Now, there's a benefit of doing it this way, and I know a lot of people think that you're breathing wrong, but there really is no breathing wrong. The only wrong breathing is not breathing. So anything that you're doing where you're breathing slow, calm, and deep is great. And what you'll find is that it will help you with relaxation. It'll actually help your blood pressure. And my suggestion would be, watch the link down below to see what happened to me years ago when I did this, the second method. And what I would suggest is to take your blood pressure first, do 3 to 5 minutes of each style of breathing, and check your blood pressure right after. And for the sake to help other people, put that information down below. Put the before and after blood pressure after the diaphragmatic breathing, and then maybe the next day, take your blood pressure and try the deep breathing with the chest and diaphragmatic breathing, the full breathing, and put your blood pressure. And try to learn about your own body and what style of breathing works for you. So if you thought this video was interesting, give me a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel. If you have any questions, ask in the comment section down below. Also, go to the playlist section of my video. That way you can learn about other ways to lower your blood pressure, such as diet and exercise.